Hey, my Legion, how y'all doing today? I'm with my good buddy John Walkowitz, and we just saw Blade Runner 2049. What'd you think of it, buddy?
That's pretty good. They did a really good job. It's a good sequel. I've read where it hasn't been doing that well at the box office. What I read, they said, that's probably a good sign since the original didn't do that well at the box office, but later became a cult classic. But I think they did a good job. I wonder if they're going to do like several different versions, like they did the first one. Shoot stuff in another 10, 15 years.
Well, I don't know, but I really enjoyed it. I thought it was good. It took its time. It unfolded and told its story very well. I mean, it was a very well-deserved sequel. And I'm no spoilers here or anything like that. I liked it. I mean, when Chris Stuckman reviewed it, he said that he felt that some audiences might not like it, like he did, I mean, the original one. Because it's not like, you know, it takes its time. It's like 2 hours and 40 minutes. But I really dug it. Lots of great visuals and stuff like that. Lots of great music and stuff. I give it a 10 out of 10, even though I don't think it was as good as the original one. But I mean, it was pretty close. It was a very well-deserved sequel.
So does that mean you give the original 11 out of 10?
Yeah.
Turn it up to 11.
Well, I give this a 10 out of 10. I give the original Blade Runner a full-on 10 out of 10. There you go. That's my crazy terminology.
Yeah, not too bad. Decent acting stuff. And you see some cameos from the original movie.
Oh, yeah, that's pretty cool.
Yeah, it was funny about the original movie. I saw an interview with Ridley Scott, who was saying, Rucker Hauer rewrote the tears in a rain scene, and yeah, I guess, I don't know, if it didn't really have much to it, so he decided to write something himself. And he came to Ridley Scott, and Scott says, yeah, he kind of rolled his eyes, oh, great, the actor wants to write. And then when he read what he wrote for that scene, Scott's jaw just dropped, and that was brilliant. And that is brilliant. If you've never seen the movie, definitely see the original Blade Runner. And the scene, Tears in the Rain, is just well done. And it was written by Rucker Hauer.
Yeah, that's cool. I wonder what happened to Rucker Hauer. You don't hear from him anymore.
Oh, he's around. I mean, don't forget he's getting up there in years.
Yeah.
I know he was in Sin City. I forget what he was in recently. Oh, Hobo with a Shotgun. I've got that.
Oh, I love Hobo with a Shotgun. Yeah. That's a great one. So is, I'm a big fan of all his earlier stuff, like Blind Fury and stuff like that, and The Hitcher, of course. I didn't think...
That one with Stallone's Nighthawk?
Nighthawks, yep.
I think that was one of the first movies that I knew.
Yeah. I mean, there were some other great ones he did. I like Blood of Heroes, too. I sure as hell didn't like Omega Doom, though. That was
The Hitcher was great.
Hitcher was fantastic.
The Hitcher started off, that was supposed to be written for Jim Morrison of The Doors.
Oh, really?
If I remember correctly. And it was supposed to be based on one of the songs from The Doors, Riders of the Storm.
Oh, cool.
I can't remember what happened, but it got changed. Then there's another actor, I can't remember who it was, if it was like Scott Glenn or somebody, that did a reading for the role that Rucker Hauer played, and I guess he was so creepy that the producer refused to leave the studio until Scott Glenn, whoever the actor was, left.
Oh, wow.
Because the actor just freaked him out so much. But something happened with that, and ended up going to Rucker Hauer.
Yeah, that was fantastic. Lady Hawk was another good one
in. Yeah, he's had success in several different genres.
But boy, I didn't like Omega Doom. Boy, I remember seeing that as like pretty much, I watched it with my dad, pretty much all it was like stuff happened in between these two buildings, and all he did was go back and forth between the two buildings, the science fiction film.
I've got all the versions of the original Blade Runner, so if you haven't seen the final
cut, cool.
We'll have to sit down and watch that sometime.
Awesome.
But it's good, because, you know, he shot like a new four scenes, I don't know how many years earlier. Wow. I did read Philip K. Dick, who wrote the book it's based on. Although he died before the movie came out.
Oh, really?
He did get to read the screenplay, and he liked what they had written for it. The book was called Do Androids Dream of Electric Sheep?
Yep.
Which wasn't his title. I think it was the publishing house's title. But yeah, I like the book too. Blade Runner seemed more like it was a small part of the overall story of
So I want to thank my buddy John for helping me with this review. And as always, everybody, please take care of my leisure.
I was going to add
okay.
There's more I think it's Bryan Cranston from Breaking Bad is producing a series. I forget what, if it's for a streaming service or a network, but it's based on Phil K. Dick's stories. I forget the name of it, but I have to check that out.
Yes.
And Jason's Legion.
Yeah.
If you really like Phil K.'s Dick stories, like Total Recall, Minority Report, Replicant, and Many Men in Castle.
Oh, yeah.
That's on Amazon. That's a brilliant one. Watch the first season. It was fantastic. So I get my round to watching the second season.
Cool. Yeah, that was called, I remember it was called Electric Dreams. And it's not the 80s movie about the guy who fell, the computer fell in love with that one guy.
Oh, it's a completely different one. TV show.
Yeah.
Dreams, that's right.
Yeah, okay. Alrighty. And then... Yeah, and if you like these reviews, please donate to my PayPal account to help me create... create future content. And I have two t-shirts available through Meme Designs. I'll put the link in the description for both of them. And like I said, take care, everyone. Leaving Edinburgh, going back to my place now. Alright, girl.